1.20 pre-release 1 is finally here, and it's got an interesting change. Let's get into it. Let's say you come home from your short hunting trip that was quite lucrative in your beautiful new cherry chest boat, and then you realize, wait a second, my bed's the wrong color. Both of them are, in this case. What do you do? Well, the pre-release has a new option for you, if you have that sort of problem. So, let's flip into creative and check it out, shall we? Just gotta find the dies. And here we are. Now, let's say you are tired of red beds and you want something more interesting. You want purple. But normally, you would have to go get wool and then get dye. Or get a white bed for this. But 1.20's pre-release 1 has the option to dye your beds. Which is a very interesting idea. So, all you really need to do is grab a few dye from your inventory or your storage, pop your beds in here, and poof! Your survival base now has those purple beds you've always been wanting. That's right, folks. This time, the change log only has one change. The ability to dye your beds. Which I know sounds like an old feature, but in this case, as we've shown, it's very clearly dyeing beds that were already dyed. Which is a huge deal. Huge deal. This has never happened before. Before, you could only dye white beds. But now, if you don't like the color you dyed your bed originally, no need to make new ones, because you can just dye it, including maybe to match your new pet sniffer, a nice red or a nice green, or maybe yellow for the snout. Ah, the sun sets in our beautiful field of pitcher plants and torch flowers, but no time to enjoy the sunset. Nope. Time to talk about more in the changelog. Now, what is it, you ask? It's simple. There's technical changes, but we're not going to go over too much detail because I'm not exactly a technical Minecraft YouTuber. I'm more of a casual, let's have fun type. But I will cover it a little bit for you. Now, as you can see in this change log, it says, added new damage types, outside border and generic kill. Now, this is interesting, because think about it. New damage types. What exactly does this entail? Who knows? But let's look at the rest of it, shall we? Because trust me, this is going to get interesting. As we enjoy our camel ride, let's discuss the rest of the technical changes. There's changes in server properties encoding, and it also says that apparently, string data sources for the data command now accept negative boundaries, which are interpreted as index counted from the end of the string. Now, I'm not sure what that means, but those of you that do may find this an interesting little change. There's also a bunch of bug fixes. And some stuff explaining some damage type stuff. It says players outside the world border are now hurt by the damage type outside border instead of in wall. Okay. Then it also says forcibly removing an entity using IE/kill command now uses damage type generic kill instead of out of world. Interesting. Now, I'm not really sure I understand much about this stuff, but as we head back to our camel, let's discuss the loot table random sequences it mentions. Now, this sort of thing, it's not exactly my forte either, but I can say that it does say it now uses random sequences to deterministically produce loot for loot tables. Which is interesting for those of you that understand the technical stuff, but me personally, I don't. But so as we enjoy the scenery with our camel, let's discuss the matter. Now, this is interesting, this stuff about the loot tables, but I'm not entirely sure what it means. If any of you know what it means, be sure to let me know in the comments, because honestly, this stuff confuses me a bit, because again, I'm not a technical Minecraft player. I'm more of a casual, let's play and have fun type, but that's just me. So if anyone understands this stuff, please let me know in the comments what exactly is going on here. But that's just me. Needless to say, this changelog is interesting. Personally, I'm not sure what to think of the technical stuff, because, yeah, I'm not exactly a technical Minecraft player. But you knew that. The more interesting stuff to me is the bed dying. Let me know in the comments what your favorite part of this particular pre-release was. I would really appreciate the input. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any more videos like this. And I will see you in the next one.